We do a lot of talking about finishes and woods and textures on our show because once you get past shape, those are the things that give a piece its true character and help define the style of the furniture. That's why we get so excited when we find a company or a person that's really an innovator in these areas. See what you think of the original designs coming up and the techniques which were used to create them.
The old post office in downtown Rochester, New York, may seem like a strange place for a factory, but that's the headquarters for Concept Grove, a production studio founded by a classically trained sculptor who saw furniture making as the best way to practice his art.
I always felt a need that sculpture is difficult to show in a house. You know, people always have wall space to hang paintings, but they can't afford the floor space. So by creating sculptural furniture, it allows it to function, and then people can have a reason to display it, and it'll sort of get, you know, two uses out of it, dual uses. It looks nice, and also you can use it as a coffee table, or you can store things in it, and so on and so forth. So that's sort of how I got into, quote, art furniture. So from that perspective, I'm not functionally fixed to make a piece of furniture a specific way. I guess I take it from a different perspective. And I really make my furniture more like sculpture or sculptural elements or surfaces or paintings. It's really, I approach it definitely as a sculptor or as from a design standpoint, not as a furniture maker.
And that means no materials or production techniques are off limits. The chests, tables, armoires, and occasional pieces we shot at the Concept Grove Studios all use medium-density fiberboard for structural foundation. But the combination of exotic veneers like lacewood, satinwood, rosewood, and curly maple with unusual surface textures and finishes have created quite a following for the company.
A lot of the textures we create literally have taken years to develop. I mean, we've been, you know, it's an evolution. I mean, they always are getting better or changing. Some of the textures are hand-carved with gouges. Some of them we use a chainsaw. Other ones we use die grinders with big spurs. And we're constantly developing and trying new textures. And I don't limit myself. Whatever I can get my hands on, I will try. Hatchets, you know, hammers, as I said, chainsaws. We will try anything. So they're unique in the sense that a machine can't duplicate these. Also, it gives them an individual quality. The technique is the same, meaning I use a gouge, but the pattern in which I carve is always different. You couldn't make them the same if you tried. So that gives each piece a uniqueness to it. So that's something that people really respond to, are the different undulating surfaces.
Grove says most of the people attracted to the pieces his company makes are extremely eager to touch them when they see them. They can't figure out what they're made of. Handcrafted textures with names like Amazon, Ding Ding, and Ingot are carved, cut, or gouged into the fiberboard. But the metallic finishes are what really complete the look.
Yeah, the majority of my finishes are copper-based, which we use real copper, and we mix that in a medium and coat the surface. Then from there, we build up what's called a polychrome finish, which is a variety of stains and glazes and chemicals that react with the copper and create a finish that of real depth with this metallic glow to it. Many times, people will look at the furniture and say, is this metal? You know, I say, well, it's wood, but it's copper coated. I've tried using synthetic materials, you know, micas. They just don't have the richness that real copper has.
The veneer surfaces and copper finishes aren't delicate either. The company seals just about everything with a catalyzed conversion varnish, so you don't have to worry about water or alcohol.
We want our pieces to be functional pieces of furniture. People live with furniture. We don't want them to be paranoid that they're going to get ruined, you know, or worry about a ring stain. You can put a glass of wine on top of it and not have to use a coaster. So we use a very durable finish, and you know, it just makes it practical. There's just practical furniture that looks good.
Unfortunately, it's a look that's fairly hard to define, but the founder uses the term classic contemporary when he describes the line.
It doesn't really fall into any one category, you know, right or left. It's actually sort of right in the middle, where I've combined exotic, radiant, you know, veneers, really unique veneers, with my carving technique and polychrome finishes, and to create a piece that one will stand out, but it doesn't scream at you. Also, it has a little touch of whimsy to it. You know, you can look at it and you might see a little kind of fun thing and you can give a little chuckle. You know, I think makes you smile. That's a nice thing. I want my pieces to sit comfortably in anyone's home, but stand out in a subtle way.
Considering the veneers and the amount of hand craftsmanship you find in the Concept Grove line, the pieces are pretty reasonably priced. Even the larger items, like the full-sized buffet console, are well under $4,000. And designer Scott Grove says the custom pieces he creates for both consumers and corporations aren't too much more than the existing pieces in his collection.
Very, very different looks. And if you'd like to find out more about Concept Grove and the other companies in this episode, we'll tell you how to get in touch in just a few seconds.